Vrindavan kaisa hai?
How is Vrindavan? This sloka is mentioning how is Vrindavan.
Vrindavan is Gopi yukta, Gopi samajukta. Vrindavan manoharam. Bahut acha. Scene, bahut acha. Drishya. Jahan Gopi nahi, wahan acha nahi.
So Vrindavan is the place of the gopis. Without the gopis, so Vrindavan is not beautiful.
So Vrindavan is prakar ek lila sthan hai, bhumi hai. Vahan Bhagwan nishchinta hokar apne lila vistar kiya tha.
In this way, Vrindavan is the place where the Supreme Lord was executing his pastimes.
And Vrindavan mein kai prakar ki sevak hai Bhagwan ki. Panch prakar.
So, and how can we serve the Supreme Lord in Vrindavan? There are five ways.
Jo Bhagwan chahte hain, जैसा भगवान की सुख होता है, आनंद होता है, ये पांच प्रकार की सेवा उसी प्रकार सेवा में भगवान को सुख प्रदान करते हैं.
So whatever the Lord likes, whatever makes him happy, there are these different ways in which we can offer this service.
भगवान की जहाँ सुख नहीं है वहाँ सेवा नहीं है.
If what we do doesn't make the Lord happy, so this we cannot call to be service, to be seva.
वो काम है.
This is lust. Or this
माया
is
माया है.
Or this is just ordinary work. This is illusion.
आत्मा काम कहते हैं इसको. आपने आपने सुख को काम कहते हैं हमारा.
So this we call work, which is for me.
तब सुख जाहे भजन कहते हैं भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर. तब सुख जाहे करीब जतन हुए पौधे अनुराग. गोपी भाव कैसा है? गोपनंदन श्री कृष्ण को जिस प्रकार से आराम हो सकता है, कृष्ण सेटिस्फाई हो सकता है, उसी प्रकार सेवा गोपी उनका धर्म है.
So in this song, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining how is the service of the gopis. So they serve the Lord in order to make him happy. This is until he's happy.
Gopi apne house ki sara kaam karte hain, lekin ye shorir se karte hain. मन जो है उनकी माइंड कृष्ण में अर्पण किया.
So the gopis, they also execute their duties in their house. They do all the service there, but their mind is always surrendered to Krishna.
संसार में जो भी काम करते हैं उसमें उनकी रुचि नहीं.
They don't have any taste by doing these other activities.
रुचि एकमात्र जैसे मिश्री अच्छा लगता है, दाऊजी में मिश्री मिलता है ना, मिश्री का भोग लगता है, मिश्री बहुत अच्छा है, स्वीट है. तो जो है कृष्ण चिंता ही, कृष्ण भावना ही अमृत है. Krishna Bhavanamrita.
So it's like when we execute this service to Krishna, then it is very sweet. It's not that like the ordinary work which doesn't have any taste, but Krishna, service to Krishna is supremely sweet.
So, इस प्रकार कृष्णा है जिन्होंने हमारे लिए सदैव हमारे हृदय में विराजमान है. हमारे हृदय में कृष्ण विराजमान है. कब से? जब से गुरु हमारे ईयर में मंत्र दिया है उसी दिन से कृष्ण हमारे हृदय में विराजमान है.
In this way, Krishna is like this, and Krishna has been established in our hearts since our guru has given us the mantra.
लेकिन हम कृष्ण को दर्शन नहीं पाया.
But we have not taken darshan of the Lord.
क्यों? ना हम कृष्ण तो हमारा हार्ट में है ये विश्वास नहीं है हमारा.
Because Krishna is in our heart, but we don't believe this. We don't trust.
हमारी बाहर की पंच ज्ञानेंद्रियों की दृश्य देखने में और लोग उसको उस दृश्य को उस दृष्टि गोचरित वस्तु को पाने के लिए हमें कोशिश करता हूँ कि आहार निद्रा भय मैथुन आदि में हमारा मन भ्रमण कर रहा है.
Because our mind is wandering and our senses are trying to experience this world.
इसलिए कृष्ण नाम करते हुए भी कृष्ण को दर्शन नहीं होता है. क्यों? नाम तो करते हैं ये शब्द मात्र ही होता है, नाम नहीं होता है. नाम अक्षर है लेकिन कृष्ण नाम नाम नहीं होता. जब नाम होगा तो उसी मुहूर्त में हम भगवान को साक्षात रूप में हमारा सामने दर्शन.
So you can, we will only be able to see them, to see him when we chant his name. If we chant his name, then he will manifest.
नाम कब होगा कि हम कृष्ण धाम में कृष्ण सर्वत्र विराजमान है. हम कृष्ण के धाम में ही अवस्थान करते हैं लेकिन हमारा मन जो है बाहर की दूर दृष्टि है, बाहर को देखता है.
And when we chant this name, we have to have the understanding that Krishna has appeared in Vrindavan, but he is also present everywhere.
इसलिए एक इंडियन एक टॉक है, बात है कि एक व्यक्ति कह रहा है कि तुम्हारा यार वो देखो पक्षी ले जा रहा है, तुम्हारा यार जो है पक्षी ले जा रहा है. एक पक्षी है वहाँ बड़े बड़े बट वो चिंता ही करते हैं. किसी वस्तु तुम ले जाओगे तो छठ आगे जैसे वृंदावन बंदर ले जाता है उसी प्रकार ले जाता है. तो एक आदमी कहते हैं देखो तो तुम्हारा यार ये वो बाढ़ ले गया तो वो बाढ़ के पीछे बाढ़ दो ऊपर को जा रहा है, वो बाढ़ के पीछे भाग रहा है.
So Maharaj is saying like there is a saying in India that they say, oh look, this bird has taken your ear. So then they say, oh, okay, you go run after the bird to get your ear.
तो कुछ दूर हम दौड़ के कोई ले जाते हैं तो एक आदमी बोलता है भाई इतना जोर से क्यों दौड़ रहा है तुम. बोले हमारा ईयर ले जा रहा है पक्षी.
So then he's running after the bird, and then someone comes and say, oh, why are you running so much? And he said, oh, I'm running because that bird over there has taken my ear.
बोले तुम देखो भाई तुम अपना ईयर तुम्हारा है कि नहीं तुम देख तो लो तुम्हारे पास तुम्हारा ईयर है कि नहीं तुमके पहले देख लो.
So he says, but first check, did you check if you have your ear with you or not?
Understand?
Do you understand?
Yes.
We are going where? विश्व के जो देख रहा है इधर को हम भाग रहा है लेकिन इसमें यदि कृष्ण नहीं होगा तो ये सब सूखा है.
So in this way we are running, but if we see all this world without Krishna, everything is dry.
Gopi जो है गोपनंदन नंदनंदन श्री कृष्ण में आशक्त है. श्री कृष्ण बिना और किसी वस्तु उनकी आराम नहीं है.
So in this way the gopis they are unhappy because without Krishna they can never be happy.
Tisha Krishnam. Tisha. कृष्ण जीदार है उनकी मन जो है सदैव उदारी देखता है.
Whatever Krishna is, the mind of the gopis there will be also there.
इस प्रकार जो गोस्वामी हुए जिस वृंदावन में अपने घर परिवार छोड़ के महाप्रभु दिखाया और वृंदावन को ये वृंदावन है ये इमलीतला है भगवान इमलीतला में इमली के पैर के इसे क्यों बैठा भगवान आया उसकी लीला स्थली को दर्शन करके उनके मन में उदय हुआ नीचे जमुना जी है यही जमुना जी में कृष्ण लीला में उन्होंने जल के लिए किया किसके साथ गोपियों के साथ.
In this way, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to show us where is Vrindavan, the places of the Leelas, and he was also meditating under the benches of the under the tree of Imli Tala in the next to the river Jamuna, where Krishna would do his lila with the gopis.
उस समय Krishna and gopis contract हुआ कि कब तक हम नीचे डूब रह सकता है.
And so Krishna was with the gopis, and so they were saying, okay, let's see who can be more time under the water.
Sabduva.
So all of them went inside.
Krishna viduva, gopi viduva.
Krishna and the gopis, they were inside the water.
So Krishna, very chalak hai.
So Krishna is very, very smart.
So Krishna, jhat. उठके उस एमली तला एमली के पेड़ के नीचे जाके बैठा और गोपी बहुत देर बाद जब उठ के देखा तो फिर उन्होंने डूबा देखा कि अभी तक कृष्ण नहीं उठा फिर गोपी डूबा फिर उठते हैं तो उठ के कृष्ण को नहीं देख करके उन्होंने बड़े वहाँ पानी में ढूंढा कृष्ण को नहीं मिला जब नहीं मिला तब राधिका जी परे क्राइंग रो रहा.
So when they were all under the water, then Krishna he came out of the water and he went to the Imritala and he hide. Then the Gopis, after some time, when they came out, or they didn't see Krishna, so they, again, they went inside. And then again, outside, and they didn't see him there, they started searching for him in the water. And then Radharani, after a long time not finding him, so Radharani came very sad and started crying.
जब गोपी रो रहा था तो कृष्ण को आराम लग रहा था क्यों?
So like when the gopis were crying, Krishna was very happy. Why?
कि देखो तुम लोग बोका.
बोका माने
बोका माने
foolish. So Krishna say, okay, you are foolish.
Why? 2 minutes से ज़्यादा पानी के नीचे नहीं रह सकता है.
Because we cannot be under the water more than 2 minutes.
और तुम लोग एक बार डूबते हो, एक बार और से जाते हो, तो तुम समझता है कि हमने वहाँ बहुत देर तक डूबा हुआ है, तो ऐसा नहीं है. जब देगा कृष्ण कहाँ है, कृष्ण बंसी बजा रहा है, कहाँ? इमली के पेड़ के नीचे से.
So they were saying, because you know that we cannot be under the water more than 2 minutes, so you were already inside for some time and then came out, but you were still thinking that I was there, but no, I was under the tree playing the flute.
बंसी धरी श्रवण करके गोपियों ने बड़े लज्जित हुआ. लज्जा हुआ क्यों? कृष्ण के पास हार गया. हारने से लज्जा होता है, हारने से अपमान होता है ना. तो गोपियों ने रो रहा था. फिर ललिता जी पहले चलो कृष्ण भी काम तब जाके राधिका जी के हाथ पकड़ करके सेवा कुंज में गया. सेवा कुंज है ना नजदीक में, सेवा कुंज में.
So the gopis were speaking, discussing in this way, and then Lalita and Radharani and all the other gopis, they went there and Krishna took Radharani by their hand and they went to Seva Kunj.
तो ये तो कृष्ण लीला है. तो महाप्रभु उस इमली के पेड़ के नीचे क्यों बैठा? महाप्रभु जाके वहाँ वही लीला उनकी याद आया. द्वापर में जो कृष्ण यहाँ मंजी बजाया, जले गल किया, वही लीला याद आया उनके मन में.
So this is the reason why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would sit under this Imli tree. He would sit there and meditate upon this Leela.
So, wahi Imli tala, jab Mahaprabhu ne apne Leela sthan ko prakat karke dekhaya, to hum us Leela sthali mein jaakar ke वहाँ प्रणाम करते हैं, उसी लीला के स्मरण करते हैं, हरि नाम के साथ उसी लीला स्मरण करना है. ब्रह्मी वो द्वादश बने कृष्ण के लिए लीला स्थाने, कृष्ण लीला स्थली में कि द्वादश वन है वृंदावन में, 24 उपवन है और द्वादश वन है. तो ये वन मन में वृंदावन में हम क्या करेंगे? वृंदावन तो जाते हैं कि ब्रह्मी वो द्वादश बने कृष्ण लीला के लिए वसति स्थल, ऐसे कुछ है.
So Maharaj is saying in this way, when we go to this Imli Tala place, which is a very sacred place of this Lila of Radha Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so we go and we meditate upon this and we offer our prayers there. Because in Vrindavan is full of places of Leela, in the 12 forest or Chovis, Chovis, how is that? Chovis.
24.
24, yeah?
Bon.
Barawan here or Chovis?
24,
whatever. So it's like 12 main forest and then 24 small forest.
12 Upavanas.
12
Barawan or Chovis Upavan?
Upavan.
So 12 main big forests and then 24 small forests.
So Mahaprabhu, काठ आते थे वृंदावन जाके वृंदावन तो अभी मंदिर है उस समय तो मंदिर नहीं था केवल एक ऐसा जंगल था.
So when Mahaprabhu went there, so there was not any temple. It was just like this only trees jungle.
Mahaprabhu ओकरुण घाट जाके छान करता वहीं जाके स्नान करते थे वहीं जाके माधुकरी करते थे.
So Mahaprabhu was doing Madhukari in Akrur Ghat.
Akrur Ghat. Akrur. Mahakrishna ko rath khada karke jab Jamuna ji mein snan kiya.
So in this Akrur Ghat was the place where by putting the chariot of Lord Krishna he took bath in Jamuna.
और उसी लीला को स्मरण करते थे. किस लीला? इस समय ओकरुर ले जा रहा था कृष्ण को, कृष्ण महादेव को गोपियों ने रथ पकड़ के खड़ा हुआ था. उसी गोपी उनकी विरह से भगवान वहाँ विरह लीला की स्मरण करते थे महाप्रभु.
So also when he was there, he was remembering this. First time when Akruta was taking Krishna away and the gopis were taking hold of the chariot and all this first time of separation, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was remembering.
Is prakar Vrindavan lila hai.
In this way there are these first times of in Vrindavan.
Gurudev, you remember the lila of Radharani and the tamarind tree? In Litala, you remember? What was that Leela? Radharani, the Imli fruit.
Yes, Imli fruit. Abhishampa. Imli.
Then after that, Radharani says, no more Imli in Vrindavan.
No.
What was that Leela?
I
have a question. Our Gaudiya Sampradaya, they are telling many Leela in our Granta. But in Vrindavan, the people tell many other Leela, not in Granta. But they are telling many stories about Krishna with devotees. Is it okay to hear all this Leela?
Usi Radha Vallabh Goswami log speaking.
Yes.
Vrindavan Vashi Vrindavashi that way think. But Mahaprabhu speak jo Leela Vallabhpur no smaran. Vallabhpur. Boy, I'm glad. Nimbarit.
Every sampradaya separate Leela.
Separate.
Acha. And in Bharaka, many Leela, no? Nikunja.
In Bharaka.
Balabhacharya.
Vishnu Swami.
Balabhacharya.
Sabari Sabari. Gauri is original Leela. Gauri Swayam Krishna Mahaprabhu.
The best is only listen to the Leela of your Sampradaya.
Not my Sampradaya, Gauri Sampradaya.
Yeah, your, our Sampradaya, Gauri
Sampradaya. Our Sampradaya. Darshan, philosophy, Asinta, Veda, Ved, Asinta, Jeev or Brahma, same. Gita speak, Mami Vamsha Jeeva Loke, Jeev, Mera, Chuta, small. Answer it. So, Mami Uttar Jeeva Loke Jeeva Uttar Sanatana. Jeeva Sanatana. So, Ma. So, Jeeva Brahma. Jeeva Brahma. Shankaracharya. Napara. Jeeva Brahma. Jeeva Brahma. Gita speak, Mami Vamsa Jeeva Loke Jeeva Bhuta Sanatana, Mami Vamsa Brahma. Mahaprabhu speak, not Purna Brahma, Chota Brahma. Brahma is a big, or Jeeva is a small. So, Jeeva Brahma bhed hai. Big, or small, bhed hai. Jeeva Brahma na para. Ye Shankaracharya speak. Mahaprabhu speak. Bhed, abhed. Brahma or Purna Brahma, same. But bhed, jeeva is small, bhagavan. Brahma is a big, anant, Akash. There is a bed. Veda bed, but tattva. Our granthas, Sundaranga.
Sundaranga Vidyavino.
Vidyavino. Asinto Veda bad, tattva. Ajinta. There is a difference. Little gold, this is a little gold or figure. Here,
mm-hmm.
Big gold, something gold here. Same. Asinda Vrindavan. Isko, jo Mahaprabhu Ajinta Vrindavan Tattva Jeeva aur Brahma mein ek vastu hote hue bhi ek chota hai, ek bada hai. To isko kisi darshan kar, Shankaracharya ki darshan kar, koi khandan nahi kar paya.
So this is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained in this way, which is Veda Veda is simultaneously one and different, just that one is small and the other one is big. So this kind of thought of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is unbreakable.
No, because there's
an explanation. I'm finished. Again?
Gurudeva Gopananda Pan Maharaj explaining that the Leelas in Vrindavan, they're full of secrets, but we should listen to them from the Gaudiya Sampradaya. Because Gaudiya Sampradaya is the original explanation of Mahaprabhu and Krishna. And Vrindavan was revealed really by Mahaprabhu. After Mahaprabhu, other people, Swami Haridas and so, they also came, but the real Vrindavan understanding is coming from Mahaprabhu. If we want to understand this special revelation which is coming now to us by Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada and his disciples, then we should be very anxious to know what was revealed by Sadhguru Swamis. What did the Sadhguru Swamis do in Vrindavan? And after Sadhguru Swamis, Shamananda, Srinivas, and Narottam Das Thakur. They were three expansions, secondary expansions of Mahaprabhu to lead the Sampradaya. And so in this way, the Vishva Vaishnava Raj Shava tries to unite. Don't change. Vishva Vaishnava Raj Shava tries to unite the devotees who are teaching Mahaprabhu's original message, which is which can save the world from the tamaguna, rajaguna, and sattvaguna, and establish the world of those who surrender in Vishuddha Sattva, in the transcendental mode of devotional service. You see, sattvaguna is not enough. Many people are trying to go to sattvaguna, but we have to go beyond sattvaguna, go to Vishuddha Sattva Sevaka, of serving Krishna only for the sake of Krishna's pleasure. And that's very difficult, because in this world we are all motivated by lust. The lust principle, I want to enjoy, I am the center. And therefore, we are in the prison of our lust. But when we come to Vrindavan, gopis, Radharani, they're only living for Krishna's pleasure. That is why some village girls have become the top gurus of the Gaudiya Sampradaya. We are following little girls of Vrindavan, and they have become acharyas. The six Goswamis, they all have their manjari form. So, who can understand that? That the little girls of Vrindavan have become the greatest teachers in the world, Sadhguru Swamis, and teaching the whole world about Vrindavan. This is unbelievable. It is completely achintya, beyond imagination, that the Sri Vrindavan Dham, Ladini Shakti, Radharani, is making a plan. And that plan is combined with Krishna's plan. And that becomes Mahaprabhu, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nayana. That is our Siddhanta. Other Sampradaya will not teach this. This you can only teach, learn in Gaudiya Sampradaya. And therefore, we are so happy to have Vishva Vaishnava Raj Sabha President Gopananda Bon Maharaj with us, so we can all together understand deeper and deeper what is the divine plan. Why Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada came to the West and gave so much. Like I was speaking in India, I was speaking with one man. He's a chief secretary of Vishwa Hindu Parishad. And he said, nobody has been an ambassador of Hinduism in the world like Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Nobody. Nobody has introduced the world to India, to Vedanta, to Vaishnava philosophy and practice. Not only that, but Bhaktivedanta Swami put the temples. Now you come to the temple, take darshan. Now you take japa, chant Hare Krishna. Now you eat prasad. Everywhere in the world, he has one single man has done that. And even Vishwa Hindu Parishad, they are basically Advaitavada followers. They are followers of Vivekananda. But when they see what Gaudiya did in the world, they say, our respect. Because everybody following Sanatana Dharma, they want the whole world to accept and to respect Sanatana Dharma. Because only if the world respects Sanatana Dharma, then the world can understand something. Then the world can have a higher dimension. Only. Without that, it is not possible. So therefore, we have a treasure. We have Mahaprabhu, we have Prabhupada's teachings. And this is already history. Everybody likes yoga. Everybody likes Ayurveda. Everybody likes Indian architecture, practically. Everybody likes India's taste and colors. Everybody likes so many things. India is very... Even everybody likes Bollywood. But even in South America, all the girls, they are dancing Bollywood dancing. Huh? But what really they like is Krishna Lila. Because now in the Western world, Maharaj, very famous holy festival. They call Festival of Color. In Europe, in every city, every year now, Festival of Color, and they play holy. But they don't know nothing about Krishna Lila.
In the mode of ignorance.
Sometimes there's also kirtan. They're doing kirtan in the holy. They have bhajaniyas playing. And so it is not in a very high understanding, but what I like to say that the whole world is attracted to Krishna. Krishna is Akila Rasamrita Murti. He is the supreme fountainhead of attraction. And the Ras Lila is the top Lila of divine. God is dancing with everybody. This principle of Ras Lila, the principle of this, is so attractive. But only with Mahaprabhu Tika, we can get the proper understanding and we can enter into connection with Vrindavan and enter in connection with our Gaudiya Sampradaya. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Why different several sampradayas? Why speak difference? And Shurdash is speaking here. Mathil letters. Maya Mori Meni Makana Kayo. This is Bachelor Russian. Speak. Mahaprabhu is a modern. Let's Mahaprabhu.
Balaba Sampradaya is Pushti Mark.
Pushti
Mark. Surdas is the. He's teaching in the spirit of Vatsalya Ras. So, in Gaudiya Sampradaya, Mahaprabhu, Radha Krishna, teaching of our Sampradaya is Madhurya Ras, the spirit of the Gopis, seva to Krishna.
South India Guru
Aishwarya. Shri Sampradaya. Madhvacharya. South India.
Forget.
Brahmavadi?
Yes.
Brahmavadi. Sai Baba?
No, something. Maharashtra.
Oh, Tukuram.
No, other.
Pandra. Pandrapur.
Pandrapur. Pakish. Shuru na.
Aishwarya. Madhvacharya.
Tatta. Four Acharya.
Tattvavadis.
Ramanuja,
Yamunacharya.
Madhya, Vishnu Shami. Ramanuja Nimbarko, Madhya, Vishnu Shami. Last Mahapuram, Pajanta, 11.
Yes.